praise the Lord.
Oh, that was for me. I'm talking about praise the Lord. The Lord is good. And his mercy endureth for all generations. I'm grateful for another opportunity to stand before you today. And I am on another note in 2024.
Amen.
2024. We ended 2023 with talking about sin. I think I done enough of that. So, but now if you love the Lord, you all don't want to praise him. Come on, help me if you can. Y'all, we're going to be talking about praising in 2024. And you ought to be able to give God some praise because he is just good. Anybody know that he's good? Well, I'm grateful for what he has done for me. I'm telling you, I need the Lord because he hears my cry. He heard my cry. Had pity on my every groan. And I made a promise that as long as I live, I was going to serve him. Amen. I've celebrated 50 years of being clean. Come on, help me. Walk again. Let the Lord save me in 1973. Come on. Walk again. I've been on the battlefield. And I am happy. I don't have no reason to be frowning.
Okay.
I don't have no reason to be fussing. I got a reason to praise the Lord. You know, that's my reason to praise the Lord. And you don't have to do what I do. But ask for me. I'm not going to even say my house. I say ask for me. I'm going to praise the Lord in 2024. Because he just been good to me. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. I'm going to be preaching from Psalm 150 and in all. Every verse in Psalm 150 is talking about praise. Now, if God can use an individual like David, he can use us. Amen. Anybody want to be used by the Lord? Well, I just want you to make yourself available to be used by God. He is a great God, and he's worthy to be praised. I thank you, all of you, for being here on this morning. Oliver's family is here again today. We thank God for them. That brother looks almost like a twin. You know what I'm saying? I met him with a joke. I said, well, he told me who you was. I said, well, you the one brought the money in. And, he didn't say no. So he might even have a little bit. Come on, help me if you can. I'm grateful. I'm just happy. I thought about my friend, my elder Gary Holly. I thought about him yesterday because he was a Texan fan. Boy, he came in here hollering and screaming and talking about, did they do it? You know what I'm saying? Boy, he loved the Texans. And I love Reverend Holly.
Amen.
You never will forget an individual like that. Them elders, boy. I mean, they, you know, him and Elder John. You can't go have a Sunday without thinking about Sunday saved. But I'm grateful. I'm grateful for knowing him. I'm grateful for Sister John. I'm grateful for Sister Holly. I remember when she first brought him in the first job. He sit right by me.
Oh my God.
And they won't ever know, who is that?
I don't know.
Is she with some, he with some high? I don't know. And then they called me in the office. Called me in Holly in the office. They want to know who. I said, I don't know nothing. But it's just good. To have some great memories of people that have been faithful in the church.
Amen.
So I pray that you can come to have a good time on the day. If you didn't, I'm going to have me a good time.
Amen.
I'm going to have me a good time. Look, yeah, I'm celebrating. Y'all see my Jerusalem hat over there? It's red. They tell me it came straight out of Israel. Yeah, Rev. Carter's mother's boot. Sister went to the room and she thought about me and brought me a hat. Ain't that good? Now my God should have this shirt made for me. Now don't y'all get jealous. I know y'all got God shirt too, but just letting you know, I really had my coat ready, but since I don't have a coat, I just put the black shirt on. Everything, I set that up. I didn't set it up. The first sentence said, lack of father. but I'm cooler. I just love that. To God be the glory, man. Look here, we're going to keep this up all year. To start having fun.
Amen.
Now, if you ain't sin, you can't have fun. Right? Sin will keep you governed down. But when you let that sin go, you can go and get loose. And have some fun. Amen. I'm going to give it back to Robert and the choir. And let y'all go ahead and have a wonderful time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. To God be the glory for all he has done. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Yeah.
This is the first Sunday of the new year.
Yeah.
Amen.
Father God, we thank you on this day.
Yeah.
This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it.
Yeah.
Father God, we give you praise every day for your goodness and your mercy. Lord, you can be God to us, and we can be to our own selves.
Yeah.
Lord, we call on you right now to come in and sit with us today.
Yeah.
We need you, Jesus. Yeah. We need you to come in and sit and we so that we can praise you and lift your name, Father. For we know it's all about you and not about us, Lord God.
Yeah.
Someone who's received a word from you that will help them
everybody here, ain't it? Sister Rita Montgomery, that's Sister Rita Montgomery. Come on, come on up here. I need you up here. Come on, I got my bands on. Come on, come on, come on. Smiley. Every time I look around, she's smiling. So thank God for her. Thank God for my God, daughters that's in the house. To that Chloe and Zoe, they brought me this shirt. You know, it wasn't planned for me to wear this today, but I couldn't find my jacket. So I think I got a black shirt. With Chloe and Zoe.
Yeah. Thank you.
Words about their grandpa on there. So I'm going to wear it today. I want you to know that I am grateful. I thank God for both of you all. And I do already know you couldn't have done nothing without your mama. So we thank mama too. God bless you all. I'm just happy. We got 360 in the house. I don't know his name. His name is 360. You remember 360? Big sister. Big sister.
Big sister.
Big sister. It's a big sister. Briscoe talked to me this week. He said, Pastor, I'm feeling kind of bad. I ain't going to be able to make it. I said, That's all. I said, okay. All right.
God.
Man can't miss church, man. You know what I'm saying? Look at him. He's standing back there. So, man, it is good when you are dedicated to the Lord. It's got to be a tragedy to keep you out of church. So we thank God for Elder Briscoe. Thank God for his daughter that's here. Oak Hill, she's in the house. Amen. She know about Big 60. Is it Big 60, Jim? Jim, he know about Big 60. And the other thing, he said he'd kill a dead skunk in the middle of the road. I never understood that because the skunk was already dead. But he said he was going to kill him again. But I am serious about having a good time in 2024. I mean, if you don't want to do it, I'm not going to try to get nobody to do something they don't want to do. But I'm doing what I'm going to do. Amen. We talked enough about sin. Everybody didn't know about sin now, though. I don't need to deal with that no more. You know what I'm saying? I don't need to put nobody's name on the marquees. I don't need to do none of that. We done with that. So we just going to praise the Lord. We're going to preach the text. We're going to have a good time in the Lord. Amen. If you ain't got no money between you and the Lord. Amen. But this is offering time here. You ain't got nothing. Nobody gives anything between you and him. And we ain't begging because, you know, we did have a brother here by the name of Jerry P. Rod that we didn't have to worry about no money. But now we got caught. Carter always sit around in the bush. You know? If we don't collect enough, Carter will get arrested. Amen. Yeah. Amen. He ain't denied that, is he? He ain't never said no. So, you know, this is how you let the Lord know that you appreciate everything he done. Amen. So, because he did what? Did he do it? Oh, how?
Jesus. We don't want to take hands.
the real thing.
God, we ask you lose this offering, God, for your glory and your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. 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 We got two David Yarns in the house today.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. My grandson, David Yarn, is here. Raise your hand, David Yarn.
Amen.
And then we got Kill. We got Kill's boy. His name is David Yarn. Amen. So glad to have both of the David Yarns in the house on today.
Yeah, amen.
Amen. Amen. So we're going to have another song, and we're going to look at a very familiar passage of Scripture,
okay.
All six verses,
all
right. Psalm 150. We've been in Psalms a long time in Bible study. Matter of fact, we're going to still go to Psalm 139, 138 and 39 on Tuesday. But Psalm 150 is nothing, every verse is talking about praise. And that's what we want to go in 2024. We want to start praising the Lord. Praising. Now, you praise any way you want to. I ain't trying to get you to do like I do. Do like you do you. But I'm going to do me. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I pray that we will continue this song all the way out of 2024. Whatever come up, put it in his hand. Not some of it, but all of it in his hand. Amen. It's good to see old Trina in the house. Yeah, what's up, T? Good, good, good. I can do that. Can't nobody else do that. Jeremy ain't gonna jump in. Amen. Yeah, he ain't even smiling no more. No, he ain't here. Don't worry about it. But in the book of Psalms, Psalms 150, it is a praise song. And David had reason to praise the Lord because David was a crook. But God saved David. And David, he started writing about stuff. And when he finished Psalm 149, he entered into Psalm 50. He just got happy. Psalm 150, verse number 1, say, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty expansion. Praise him for his mighty deeds. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with trumpet sound. Praise him with harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with string instruments and pipe. Praise him with loud cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Then he said, praise the Lord. And I just want to talk just a little while from the topic of in 2024. Let's start. Amen. In 2024, let's start. Amen. Let us bow. Gracious Father, Lord, we come now in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus. Lord, we come, Lord, asking for preaching power. Lord, that you touch these your people, dear Lord. Lord, and we ask this in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus. Amen, and thank God. Amen, amen. This is a plea. You may be seated. You know, all we're doing is asking. You know what I'm saying? We want you to start something new.
Amen.
We know this is a Baptist church.
All right.
You know, we still can have a little fun. And we still can do some running. I heard Elder Jones say, this is the only place that you can get as loud as you want. And you won't go to jail. Come on, help me if you can. Amen. So we you know, I understand that sin, you know what I'm saying, the devil. I mean, he's bold. You know, he'll tell you, he raised your hands. Man, put your hand down. You know what you've done last night. But your devil will make you put your hand down. He'll make you shut your mouth because you know what you done. Come on, help me if you can. But in 2024, you're going to get your praise back. Come on, help me if you can. There was a time when we all praised the Lord until we got mixed up in stuff that we ain't had no business doing. But we're going to get back to praising the Lord. You know what I'm saying? And look here, we understand everybody don't praise the same way. But you just praise in your way. Come on, help me if you can. Am I making any sense here? You praise God your way. Well, God will be satisfied. And I say, let's start, guess what? Acting arrogant. I got that highlighted on my paper. I said, acting arrogant. Now, I'm gonna tell you what arrogant means. I'm gonna go back to the rest. Praise in the Hebrew is halal, meaning arrogant. You know what I'm saying? Meaning to make claims to superior importance of being proud. See, that's what that arrogance means. You done ran across some arrogant folks, man. They just don't care. They're going to do whatever they want to do when they get ready to do it. And they'll say some stuff that you say, ooh, that was arrogant. You know what I'm saying? But God, I'm looking for some arrogant praising individuals in 2024. And you don't have to worry about an individual not understanding you. Long as God understands you, you go ahead and give God some praise because he's worthy of the praise. Not only should you start acting arrogant, but boastful, insanely renewed and reowned. In 2024. Did y'all understand what I said? I said, now you need to. That's the title right there. Let's start acting arrogant, boastful, insanely, renewed, reowned, in 2024.
Amen.
All right, ain't that something?
Amen.
But look here. In order to do that, I need us to help me with some things.
All right,
so I got on my paper right here. Say, let's start standing,
shouting,
for his what?
Strength
in his sanctuary. Yeah. Anybody know that? Or you relying on God's strength?
Yeah.
Right now today, even sitting down in that chair, you relied on God's strength. And then another thing, to even get up out of the chair, you relying on God's strength. So whatever God has done for you, it's all right for you to say, Lord, thank you. Ain't nothing wrong with that. You know, man, it's all right to wave your hand if you don't want to. But whatever way you want to praise the Lord, that is what I'm asking you to do in 2024. And watch God get busy in your life. And you're going to need the Lord because the devil going to get busy in yours. Huh? Am I making sense here? When you start doing what God say do, then the devil going to what? He's going to show up and try to show out in your life. But look here, I already know that God is a winner. He ain't never lost nothing, man. You know what I'm saying? When you look at God and look all what he has done, he don't know how to lose. He don't know how to be second and third. He's a number one God. So I want you to praise the number one. And you never know, God might bless you with something. Come on, help me if you can up in here. Anybody want to be blessed by the best? Let's start praising God in 2024. I mean, he's worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised. Now, I'm telling you, when you do this, the devil says, man, put your hand down. I'm telling you, he's just that bold. But you got to fight.
You got to fight,
you know what I'm saying? And look what it says in verse number 1 and verse number 2. It says, praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Are we in the sanctuary?
Yes,
come on, help me if you can. Say, praise him in his mighty expression. Did you praise him when you ride in your car? All you got to do is look up.
Yeah.
That's his mighty expression. All you got to do is look up and look at an airplane. Ain't that something to praise God about, airplanes?
Yeah.
You know, I'm wondering how all these airplanes, he might have 1,000 airplanes just flying, but they got it all set up.
Yeah.
And boy, them right brothers, but God had to give them that.
Yes, he did.
God had to give them that. What I tell you, boy, God is an awesome God. Everything you see is because God okayed it.
Yeah.
Huh? So I'm trying to get you to understand that it's all right to praise the Lord. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to be quiet. You know what I'm saying? It's all right to holler every now and then. You know what I'm saying? I remember at First John. Now, Sister Holly and Erica, they remember Sister White. She, I didn't understand. She just get that there. Be doing all that stuff. Ooh, Holly is running. I said, man, what is wrong with her? You know what I'm saying? Everybody, she didn't care about everybody messing with her. Even Pastor Davis even told her she needed to stop. She said, I just can't stop. She didn't do all that, man. Am I telling the truth? You know what I'm saying? Her name was Sister White, man. You know what I'm saying? And now I see what was wrong with her. She was filled with the Spirit of God. She was thankful for what God had done in her life. And she just could not sit still and don't do nothing, man. You know what I'm saying? So I wonder, do we have any Sister White in the house? Ain't nobody gonna bother, you know what I'm saying? You can pray them as long as you want, loud as you want, because he is worthy to be prayed. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Look here. So, verse number 2 say, praise him for his mighty deeds.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. All of us can identify with the mighty deeds.
Yeah.
Have God done anything in your life?
Yeah.
I'm talking about some stuff that nobody else know about. God has done some things in your life. And look here now. I raised my children. That when somebody do something for you, they raise and say thank you.
Thank
you. Huh? Yeah, you need to say thank you. So if God have done anything for you, you need to say thank you. You know what I'm saying? And because I just brought up my kids, I want you to know I'm starting a youth ministry next Sunday. I need them children over there, and I'm gonna talk to them about something that people are scared to talk to them about. Come on, help me if you can. I'm going to talk to them about some stuff that their own pastor went through.
Yeah.
And look, you know what I'm saying? And look at it now. God can use anybody.
Yeah.
And I'm making it to say God can use anybody. So regardless, you know what I'm saying, what the world is saying.
Yeah.
I was in IHOP yesterday.
All right.
I ain't going to be that long. I was in IHOP.
All right.
Amen.
And they said, how many you got? I said, I'm by myself.
Mm.
And so they sit me on down. Anybody in there? Ain't nobody wearing no mask. I got scared. Well, people right on side of me there talking, they ain't got no mask. Over here, they ain't got no mask. Nobody got some mask. I can't eat them. I can't eat them. You know what I'm saying? Guess what I did, Rob? I raised my hand and said, can I get mine to go? And I was so hungry, Rob, until when I got out of there with my bag, I left my back patch up and ate in the trunk. You know what I'm saying? I had to eat right then, man, but I was just, I'm trying to obey what thus says the Lord. And the Lord says, you need to have a mask on, wear a mask. You know what I'm saying? But I found out that most folks don't want nobody to tell them that.
Right.
I know I'm right about it. People just want to do it. I do whatever I want to do. You know what I'm saying? And I always tell you, I got a member here that he say, I do whatever I want to do. And you know what I told him? I said, you're right.
But you can't do it here.
You can't do it here. But again, we need to do what God is saying do. And if COVID-19 came back, where you at? Now you see, I want to hug Rita Montgomery. She got a mask on. What I look like running up there and I ain't got no mask on? She might have went the other way. We got to respect what people are doing, and we got to respect what thus says the Lord in the Bible. You know what I'm saying? God said, praise him if he's done anything for you. I can understand if God ain't done nothing for you. You just sit on down. You ain't got to raise your hand. You ain't got to do nothing.
Come on,
brother. All right.
Well.
Oh, look here. I guarantee you, boy, when you start getting in them 50s and them
60s.
Oh, amen. I'm talking about looking around. I never thought that it was a blessing just to get up and go to the restroom. Sometimes it get hard, man, getting out of that bed, getting to the restroom. I'm thinking about now getting one of them grab balls, you know what I'm saying, on the side there, man. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it's hard. Your legs get a little weak. Come on, help me if you can. Man, it takes a lot to do things that we normally took for granted. So if you can do any of these things, you owe God praise, man.
Yeah.
If you made it from your house to here, you owe God praise. Come on, help me if you can. And when I think about people sleeping under the bridge, people on the corner, and look what God done for us.
Yeah.
You gonna sit here like you ain't got nothing to praise God for, man. Look here, if God got you, if you got a mattress with a blanket, come on, help me. That's enough to praise the Lord about. Come on, help me if you can. If you got water in your house, that's enough to praise the Lord about. Better not have no heat in the cold. That's something, boy, I'm getting happy up in here already. I'm saying, we done got too quiet in here. We need to understand that. If it had not been for the Lord, you wouldn't have nothing. Come on, help me if you can. I keep telling you all the time that they ain't got room for you up under the bridge, baby. They'll take you and they'll have you singing for them up under the bridge. Come on, help me if you can. I've been telling them all the time, it's order under the bridge. You can't come under the bridge and just take over. You know what I'm saying? You got to do what is the leader there. But everybody won't do what they want to do. You can't do that. You can't do it here. You ain't going to be able to do it in heaven.
Yeah.
If you make it.
Amen.
Look here. Am I making sense here? They say you need to praise God for his strength. In his sanctuary.
Yeah.
Now there's another psalm. It says something say, enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. They say, bless his name. How many know how difficult it is to get to church now?
Yeah.
Folks flying, everybody's beating.
Yeah.
And so if you make it here, it's enough for you to say, Lord, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Amen. So I'm glad. But with all that in mind, I want you to understand, we need to do some things for the Lord.
That's right, Pastor.
After all he done for us. You know what I'm saying? I know I'm not the only one guilty here. I'm just only somebody that's bold and bad enough to tell that he ain't been right all his life. There's some old folks that ain't done y'all look all that, but y'all done did some stuff too. You just ain't telling nobody, but God know about it. And God is expecting a praise out of you because you and him know what he delivered you from. You and him know. Am I making sense up? Man, look here. We ain't all been right all our life. Man, look here. I'm telling you, boy, look, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I wouldn't be behind this pulpit right now. Guess where I'd be? I'd have been, I don't know what happened in the grave. Come on, help me if you can. I would have been in the grave.
Amen, Pastor. Amen.
I'm trying to help somebody. So the next thing I need you to understand. So I got on my paper, unless. Unless. You know what I'm saying? What do I got? Unless. Unless. You know what I'm saying? My second part. Let me go to the second part. Unless. That's less. Me. L-E-T-S. Me and us. You know what I want y'all to do? You know what I want them to do? Stop being silent.
Okay.
And start singing, shouting, and sliding. I wonder what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? We just got through singing. Did we just get through singing?
Yeah.
Shout, you can shout every now and then. And what about that slide? Come on, help me with that. Ain't he good?
Yeah.
Ain't he good? Everybody know you're good. I'm talking about have some fun in here, man. Say, let folks know that you are excited about the Lord. Y'all ain't like y'all don't know how to slide. Y'all slid back in there. Come on, help me together. I don't know about the slide in them parties that we all used to go to. They were sliding in there. They were sliding. When they slide, y'all ain't like y'all don't know what I'm talking. Y'all know what the slide is, but now you can slide and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for what you've done. Hallelujah to your name. Ain't nothing wrong with it, Reverend. Revelation, we be sliding, don't we, Reverend?
Yeah.
Man, 90-something years old, he's still over there. Ain't he good,
Reverend?
Yeah, so look here. We need to start praising the Lord. Now, I know we got some dignified folks. That's all right. That's the way you want to pray. I ain't. You can do whatever you want. But if we got some sliding folks, slide. If we got some hollering folks, holler. And we got some white wailing folk. Wave your hand. Come on, help me if you can. Well, whatever it is, you know what I'm saying? That you can give God some praise in your way. Ain't nobody trying to make you do nothing, but you need to give God some praise because he's worthy. Can I get two or three witnesses together? He's worthy of the praise. Come on, help me if you can. Just because he woke you up this morning. Guess what else I'm trying to do? I'm trying to listen better, Reverend. I'm trying to listen better. You know, I got this HR manager that she's the manager.
Yeah.
At Disney over there, you know, the one sitting back there. You know.
Yeah.
And she's over a whole bunch of half the company.
Yeah. Amen.
And she always trying to tell me what to do.
Right.
But guess what?
What you talking about?
Guess what? You know, I'm starting to listen now.
Right.
A lot of stuff she saved me, it's some good stuff.
Yeah.
Come on, help me. Did I say that? Remember Irby used to say, did I say that? You know what I'm saying? But more than 90% of the stuff she saved, it right, just don't want to hear it right there. Come on, help me if you can. She will tell you the right thing. She ain't scared to tell you the right thing. And I thank God for, I'm saying it on TV, I thank God for everything you told me.
Amen.
What did I say? Did I say that?
Yes,
I mean, she know how to deal with people. She work with people.
Yes.
But like I said earlier, sometimes folks don't know about telling nothing.
Yeah.
I know I ain't the only one.
You're right.
Yeah. I ain't the only one. And people want to do whatever they want to do. Because they tell me I'm wrong. I do whatever.
Yeah.
I want to do. Yeah. And then she ain't no more than that tall. You know what I'm saying? And I'm looking down on
her. Oh, yeah.
But it be right. Yeah. Come on, help me if you can. But it be right. Am I making any sense here?
Yeah.
Look here. And clean it, I don't know what. Rep Stewart came to the house yesterday to help me out with some stuff. The man used the restroom, Rob.
Oh, okay.
And he said, man, perhaps it's so clean in this house. So I'm scared to put the trash in a can. I just put it in my pocket. told them the maid had left. I told them the wrong thing, Robert.
Oh, yeah, okay.
You know what I'm saying? Ain't no maid because they live here, don't they?
Yeah.
But this one, no, this is the cleaning lady. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but she is very clean. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, you got to deal with it, though. You know what I'm saying? She's clean. You got to clean.
Yeah,
you can't put this down. She want it up.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, God got me on another level, another journey now. You know, I come from the hood.
Yeah.
And then I ain't never had a garage door open in my life.
Right.
But now you pull up, man, I said, man, hit that little button and your garage will go up.
Yeah.
Ain't that something? Central Ave heat, nobody had no Central Ave in the heat in the hood. You had window units. Come on, help me if you can, man. I'm going somewhere with this, you know what I'm saying? Because God got you on another train now, you know what I'm saying? He said, because this train is bound for glory. Y'all remember that? Because this train is bound for glory. We need to understand, we need to get on the train and start acting like we got some sense. And ain't nothing wrong with being clean. Ain't nothing wrong with giving God some praise. Ain't nothing wrong with waving your hand, you know what I'm saying? Because look here, if it had not been for God, you wouldn't even be able to raise your hand. I ain't on the crook now. I know y'all looking good now. Y'all ain't, I ain't on the crook, you know what I'm saying? Reverend, I ain't on the crook in here.
No, you're not, brother.
Huh?
No, you're not.
What are you talking about? You ain't never done nothing. Sister Ruby say, well, you don't know. Sister Ruby said, I believe it. Come on, help me if you can. But I'm trying to tell you the reason why I praise the Lord, because God has been good to me. God has saved my life. God has gave me a job. God gave me a house. He gave me another wife. Am I making sense up in here? So you can sit there and act dignified all you want to, but you better get out of my way. Come on. When I get ready to pray, I'm coming down. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to give God some praise because he's been real good to me. Am I making sense in here?
Yeah.
Act like y'all don't know how to slide. Y'all know about the slide, man. You know what I'm saying? But the third thing I see, who said that?
I know.
Yeah. Well, I don't know about them house boys when we were 15, 14, 15. We were sliding and everything, doing the bump and all that. But look, God had delivered us from that. You know what I'm saying? We need to start doing some things that will draw.
Yeah.
We want to draw.
Yeah.
That's why I want to teach these children. That's why I want to teach the team, because they need to understand that if they don't abide by the rules,
you're
going to miss out on some stuff.
Yeah.
Amen.
And I know they got all kind of books for you in school, but now the best book you can get into is this
one.
Yeah, I hear that. That's the best book that you can get into. But the third thing I see in him is that not only should we start standing, shouting
all right.
for his strength
yeah.
in his sanctuary.
All right.
And let's stop being silent and start singing.
Yeah.
You can sing along with Greenwood.
Yeah.
Shouting.
Yeah.
You can shout along with Robert.
Yeah.
And when you get happy, you can slide
yeah.
a little bit.
Yeah.
And B,
yeah.
number three, the third thing, and B, servants.
Okay.
That stand and say something
all right.
about your Savior. Okay.
Yes.
You don't have to be in the choir to say, he's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. All you can say, ain't he good?
Yeah.
You can identify
yeah.
when Green would say, in his hand, yes, Lord, put it in my hand. You can say something. This song saying that you need to stand up and say something.
All right.
Yeah. And he talking to you. They get one individual stand up and say, Lord, thank you. You don't have to be ashamed. That's what I'm saying. You can get as loud as you want. And you can have some fun in church. Your children need to know about things that go on in church. How do you think I still know about Sister White what things that we wasn't supposed to do in church? Because it was some ladies, it was some men now that guided us in the right direction.
Yeah.
And most times it was behind one little door where they had about 7-8 children in there.
Right.
They called it the men's Sunday school class.
Okay.
Anybody know anything about the men's Sunday school class? That's where you learn all the stuff that you need to know. And see, Sister Shield is over there at Berean now. But everybody went to 1 John to know about Sister Shield. And Sister Shield was not scared. You know what I'm saying? She going to make you sit down. Certain things you just could not do at 1 John when Sister Shield left church. Then we had a choir director by the name of Pat Allison, Robert. She would hit you.
All right.
And she wasn't playing. You going to sing them songs. And guess what? I keep trying to tell you all the time. We didn't have no screen. You better go home and learn that song. And you better not come back here without knowing all them words. You know what I'm saying? And I dare you not to do it.
Come on, Pastor.
You better make sure you got them songs. And then, by the way, Brother Ford, don't you come in here no more without with no one set or sausage and biscuits. Bring me one, too. But I'm so glad they was bold, man. That's it. But it helped us.
Yeah.
It helped us. We didn't want to do it, but we were scared not to do it.
All right.
Amen. So, Sterling, you need to stand and say something about your Savior. Have he done anything for you?
Yeah.
If you ain't got nothing else to say, you can say, because he woke you up this morning. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. You was able to get down on your knees, you know what I'm saying? You was able to go to the restroom. I didn't know that. Man, that's a blessing. Don't ever get that out of your mind. When you get up and get out of that bed and walk into the restroom, that's a blessing. When you take care of your business and get up, it's another blessing.
Amen.
You got folks, man, that can't get out the bed.
Amen.
You got people that can't walk. You know what I'm saying? And here you are complaining because you got to get up and go use the restroom.
Yeah.
You know, we complain about everything. Man, I had to go use the restroom. But stop eating so much. If you don't want to go to the restroom, man, you know what I'm saying? Look, but I thought about the way God got our bodies set up, man. Look here. That he gives us that thing that we need. And then we got a release system.
Yeah.
So you can praise him just about your body. There's so many things that you can praise God about. I mean, you're able to see, you're able to think, you're able to, oh man, he's just so good. He's so good. And he got a whole bunch. He says, now I like this scripture. He says, your eyes have not seen, your ear have not heard. All the things that God has prepared for you. And look at all the stuff we see now. But God said he got some stuff up there.
Yes, he does.
That eyes ain't never saw.
Never seen.
Man, he got some songs, Robert, y'all ain't never saw up there. Man, come on, help me if you can. Man, he got the streets are paved with gold.
Yeah.
The streets are paved.
Man, we got so much stuff to be thankful for.
My Lord.
Amen. Right.
We got stuff to be thankful. There's some people out on the streets.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah.
And here we are. We got everything we need.
Yeah.
And we arguing. And we fussing. We fighting. And God said, I need you to stop all that and just start doing some praising in him. Man.
Yeah.
You know, let these children know. You don't want these children to come up and thinking to be scared to praise the Lord, man.
Yeah.
You need to praise him in your house, man. You know what I'm saying? You need to praise him on the way to church, man.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Look here. I'm going to tell you this, but I got to tell you one more thing about that little short woman back there.
Okay.
She got a son, by the name Gerard. He's about this tall. He's about that big.
Uh-huh.
And he told me he's scared of
her. All right.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
Talking about that shot.
Yeah.
He way up here.
Yeah.
He way like that.
Yeah.
But she said, I mean, sit out.
That's my
sit out.
Amen.
He been trained right.
That's right.
All three of her children were trained right.
Amen.
They all got trained in the law.
Yeah.
And she was a single parent.
Yeah.
So I'm saying this to all these single parents that they're saying, you can do it.
Because
you got an example back there. You can do it.
Yeah.
And all your children will respect you.
Yeah.
They will. Look here. I got one more point, but they all checking me out. You know what I'm saying? Gerard wanted to go to the movies with me.
Well.
Curtis wanted to do some stuff with me.
Okay.
The other little baby boy, he just looking. Then they had another boy, adopted son, Maceo. He was checking me out.
Amen.
I wanted to make sure.
All right.
she married an individual, they're going to treat her right. Yeah. Them boys, they ain't playing. Anybody here got any mama that you ain't playing about? Don't raise your hand here. Look out. Oh, no, Davion, he's hurt. Well, I was talking to the other Davion, but he raised his hand so quick, man. Look here. He said, man, look here, I best with kill if you want to. That's all I'm saying. Man, he said, yeah, pastor, I know your pastor would mess with my mama. Yeah, Davion ought to get mad. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about both of these Davion now.
Amen.
You know, don't you want to mess with them parents, man?
Amen.
But God is the one that gave you them parents.
Amen.
God is the one that has been providing for you all of your life.
Amen.
And so every now and then, you ought to say, Lord, thank you for what you have done. Thank you, Lord, that I'm not in the penitentiary. Thank you, Lord, that I'm not in my grave. Thank you, Lord, that I got a place to sleep. It's so many things that we can thank God for.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
It ain't nothing wrong with it. It ain't nothing wrong with it. But look here. I'm trying to get out of here.
Amen.
You need to be servants that stand and say something about your Savior.
Yes, sir.
And if you believe what the old preacher said, Lord, y'all remember
all right.
Them old time preachers. They would say after they had stood, shouted and slid a little while, Lord, for your Savior. You know what I'm talking about. He's the one who died. Didn't he die? That's what they used to say. He died. Didn't he die? But early Sunday morning. Didn't God get up with all power in his hand? Ain't that good news? That's enough to praise God about. Because he died. Didn't he die? He stayed. Paul seen it up on the cross. Paul seen him when they stretched him wide. Paul seen him they lift him high. Paul seen him die. And then you can hear Paul saying, man, he talking about he the Lord. He talking about he this and he that. Everybody here never act like Paul. I told him, don't worry about me. I don't believe in the Lord. Many years ago, they buried me face down and tell the whole world, I can't tell you the rest of it. Thank God good. Anybody here that was not believing in the Lord, you've done whatever you want to do. Didn't nobody tell you nothing. But God, God showed up in your life the same way he did Paul. Not Paul down to the ground. I know it's good. I know it's good. Because I said the way the old folk, they would say, it's all right. I always tell you, everybody can cook, they tell you. And they give you stuff. And you go home and you taste it. You say, it's all right. And the Lord said, well, you talk about me like that every Sunday. I'm all right. All right. All you do, you holler, you say, I'm all right, so I must not be all right. That's why I changed the way. I ain't trying to be like nobody else, but I changed mine. Because God ain't all right with me. I said, God is not all right with me. Can I tell you why? Because if he's just all right, he wouldn't have died for me. If he's just all right, he wouldn't have gave me all the things that I need. But I think about how he picked me up and turned me around. Ain't God good? That's why I say, I know he's so good. Ain't he good? Ain't he good? Anybody know he's good? I know he's so good. Shout yeah! Will you say yeah? We got this slide music in here. Come on, help me if you can. I need some slide music. Anybody want to slide? Let's slide. Come on, let's slide. Slide, 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 because God is really good. He really is good. And I think about him every day. I don't take it for granted that I got a meal to eat. I don't take it for granted that I got a wife. I don't take that for granted. No. I don't take it for granted.
Glory.
That Lord let me be over church.
Amen.
I don't take it for granted.
Amen.
That I've been on my job almost 40 years.
Amen.
And pretty much do whatever I want.
Amen.
No. I don't take that for granted.
Amen.
That's why I praise the Lord. For what he's done. I thank God for my shirt that I got on.
Okay.
Well.
You know, man, they took some thanking to come up with this.
Amen.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
Amen.
And I got a grandson here. That guy wrote me a letter, man.
Well.
Can you imagine that there? He wrote me a letter. He told me that he loved his papa. And that he looks up to me. Ain't that something? When your grandchildren tell you that they look up to you, I'm a good role model. And he loved me. I would have cried blurry standing there. You know what I'm saying? You know how we are, we don't want to cry. But I got my card. That's for my birthday. And I appreciate the day that, that's my grandson. He played football for TSU. And they call him the preacher of the team. That mean a lot to me. That mean a lot to me. And they don't even want to go on the field and say, well, they don't even need to pray for us. That means a lot. But my two granddaughters, that's right there, they bought enough for me to buy me this shirt, had this shirt. You can't buy this, I don't believe. I think you have to have it made, I don't know. I'm gonna believe you have to have it made, you know what I'm saying? Even if they didn't buy it, I don't believe you have to have it made, special made, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna take it like that, you know what I'm saying? But it's special made, you know what I'm saying? Special made, you know what I'm saying? And then, man, I got over, maybe almost $3,000 for my birthday.
Yeah.
That little sharp woman, boy, she know how to give. She talks to her. She gave me a whole bunch of money. And Yeah, Trina, Daddy, Trina's here. Brother Grace gave us two slabs of ribs, a big old cake. You know what I'm saying? And then he's gonna tell me how not to eat much. I call him, man, how you gonna tell me how to eat and you gave me all this stuff? You know what he tell me? I meant to tell you it's in moderation, Pastor. But it's good when people care enough about you.
That's right.
To do something for you.
Yeah, thank you.
And I appreciate everybody that gave me some on Cash App. I don't know if this is a word or not, but I've been saying it for a long time, bro. I mean, your kindness will never be obliterated. Is that a word? That's a word, eh? Obliterate. Yeah. If it ain't no word, that's my word.
I know
it means so much that they didn't even put it in the dictionary. But I'm grateful. Now, back to seriousness. If you're here today and you can't have no fun, you got stuff going on in your life and it's taking your joy away from you. You know, I don't know how to be fake. I really don't know how to be fake. You know what caused an individual to be mad, sad, and unhappy? 9 times out of 10, it's sin. Huh? The devil will tell you, shut up, put your hand down, and you better not stand up no more. Because I know what you done last night. That's what the devil do. See, only way you're going to have some joy, you got to get Jesus in your life.
Yeah.
The devil don't give joy. The kind of God joy he give is sin.
Yeah.
Am I making sense? If you love your children, you're going to tell them the truth. So I'm hoping that y'all have me a room full of children next Sunday. Because I don't know how to lie to you. I'm telling the truth about a man named Jesus.
Amen.
That spared my life. Right down there on Cutter Street by Berlin Church. That's where I should have died, right there. But God saved me right there. And Lord, again, give me happiness. If you're here on a day and you don't have a church home, first of all, not a church home, but if you don't have salvation, salvation is the first thing. You need to get saved. If you don't know or how you got saved, then you need to get saved. If you're here today and you don't have a church home, it's good to have a church. It's just like having a Memphis Press when you got a church home. Sometimes you might be in need. You might need a word. You can always come to the church for help. So if you're here, I've given you 2 calls. You need one more call, which is prayer. You need prayer. I want you to come down now. And I want you to know this. Well, I don't even want to know what you need prayer for. All I'm going to do is lay my hand on you and give you a word that will direct you to God. Ask him. Let him do the delivery. Amen. I don't have that kind of power. You know what I'm saying? Will you come? Why don't you stand to your feet? Maybe one more that want to come. Will you come? You might just be proud. You might want to just be a member. You need salvation. Either one of those. Will you come? Maybe one. Maybe two. this side. Where you coming? And we pray that God will give you enough time to make the right decision. Because it'll be yours to give an account one day. Amen. It will be yours to give an account. I heard Pastor King say that, you know, that I'd rather live right. Some people don't believe in God. I'd rather live right and then get to heaven and it is a God. Than to live any kind of way and get there and have to pay for all them sins. If that's just live right.
Amen.
So, I thank God for all the ones that came.
Jones is coming, asking for prayer for bereavement for Sandra Brooks, her cousin Sandra Brooks, and the loss of her husband and niece. And then also prayer for the Jones family, the Elder Jones family, because they lost his nephew, Robert White.
Mm. A lot going on, isn't it? Yeah. It's a lot going on.
Yeah.
Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Thank you. Well, thank you, Sister Rita.
Montgomery being in the house. She's been gone for a while, and we thank you, Lord, for her being with us on today. God bless you. And we're getting ready for a very important part of our service. If you can stay, you want to get the Holy Communion before you go. I know it's been kind of late, but we are going to have communion on today. So we're going to get ready. I'm asking that you that's left behind would just be praying and asking God to please forgive you for anything that you may have done or said. And we'll be back in a minute. Amen.
Amen.
Savior Jesus Christ, we come, Father, with bow our head and on submit to heart to give you thanks, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for another blessed year, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for being in the house of the Lord another time, one more time, Lord. This first Sunday, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Of taking this communion, Lord. Lord, we just want to come confessing our sins and asking for forgiveness, Lord. We're going to repent, Lord, of our sins this morning, Lord, before taking this supper, Lord.
Yes.
Lord, we just want to make sure our hearts are right, Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Minds are clear, Lord. Everything is in order, Lord, before taking this Lord's supper.
Yes.
The first Lord's supper this year, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, you just keep us, Lord, in a mighty way, Lord. Touch our families, Lord. Bless us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We ask and pray. Amen. Thank God.
Amen.
Close your eyes and lift your hands toward the sky.
Oh,
just call on.
Has everyone been served who wanted to be served? Let me ask you now to stand for a moment of silent prayer between you and the Lord. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus in the night in which he was betrayed took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Amen.
Amen.
I want to thank all the visitors that are here, especially to the Oliver family. I'm going to call Kim. I'm going to call Kim, let her know everybody was here. But that's the only one missing.
Right.
I'm still going to call.
Thank you.
But we pray that God will give you all a blessed rest of the day. May God bless you and keep you, is my prayer. And whenever you have an opportunity, we would love to have your presence. Amen.
Amen.
We might even try Bible study on Tuesday night. 7:15. Amen. God bless you. Keep you in my prayer. Oh, yeah. Did anybody want to have a word? Well, Carl just reminded you. You want to have a word? You can at this time.